Get your posture right. Sit straight. Place your feet flat on the floor. Take a deep breath. Now 10 seconds to start. 5 seconds. Start.
I must congratulate you on maintaining high academic standards in your university. It has been said in certain quarters that for the last few years, some of our universities have relaxed their standards. I cannot verify how far it would be correct to say so, but if there is any truth in it, this trend is to be deplored and discouraged, because universities must always look ahead, and after imparting education must of necessity be upright, even strict in the matter of conferring degrees, destinations, or honors. You have done the right thing in sticking to this ideal from the very beginning. I am one with you that in order to be fully useful to the people for whom a university serves, it ought to be a teaching body. I am glad that in your planning you have kept this point in view. I hope the building which you have been good enough to invite me to open today marks the beginning of your undertaking in that direction. Apart from imparting education, which is after all the real aim of a university, it will also help you to coordinate and centralize your academic activities. What has particularly pleased me in the Vice Chancellor's address, in his reference to the fact that your university is likely to provide a great meeting place for the different racial and linguistic groups inhabiting Assam. My own view is that a university, besides being a seat of learning, should also be a center of real cultural activity for the mixing of people professing different faiths, speaking different tongues, and having different customs and traditions. No other place can be more suitable than a university. This is because a university is singularly free from any kind of bias and the din and turmoil of politics. It provides an ideal atmosphere for all people to come close together and understand each other. I need hardly point out that you will be rendering a great service not only to your state but to the whole of India. If you keep this objective before you, you will have rendered a great service to the nation if by sticking to your resolve you succeed in bringing all these groups together by providing them equal opportunities, thereby promoting mutual understanding and the good of all. I am thankful to the Vice Chancellor for having invited me to open this building and for giving me an opportunity to address you today. I wish your university a bright future and hope it will succeed in tiding over the difficulties and will be counted as one of India's great seats of learning and education.